وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ولا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. عظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصاب سيد الشهداء أبي عبد الله الحسين. Dear brothers and sisters, today is a day of tragedy, a day in which Ahlul Bayt عليهم السلام suffered a great deal. The entire battle, the entire events that you've been hearing about for the past 10 nights, the martyrdom of Al-Qasim ibn al-Hasan, the martyrdom of Al-Akbar, the martyrdom of Al-Abbas, the events that you've been hearing for the past 10 nights, all occurred on this one day. That's when it all happened. The battle took place shortly after Salat al-Subh, as it will be narrated to you shortly. And then it was over shortly after Salat al-Dhuhr as well. Didn't take too long. About 4 or 5 hours after Imam Hussein admonished the army of Umar ibn Sa'd, telling them and warning them of the consequences of fighting against him, then they did not listen to him and they started the battle. Even though Imam Hussein had only about 100 people with him, 72 companions and 18 of his households, even though they were fighting 100,000, yet the men whom he had with him were so brave and strong and mighty that the battle still took 4 or 5 hours. That's because they went there with their understanding. As the Imam, alayhi salam, when he addresses them, especially when he addresses Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, he says, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّكَ مَضَيْتَ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ مِّنْ أَمْرِكَ. I bear witness that you came to fight with understanding, total understanding of what you were doing. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, today is not a day of laugh. A day where you join Imam Hussein alayhi salam. A man comes to visit Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam on the day of Ashura. By the name of Du'bul al-Khuza'i, he says, Ya Du'bul, do you know what day today? He said, what is it? He said, it's the day of Ashura. And the Imam was crying. He said, Ya Du'bul, do you know that this is the day when my grandfather Imam Hussein got martyred? And he asked him to recite some poetry, some verses of poetry, to commemorate this great tragedy. And it is said that the family of Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam came. He put a curtain. The lady sat behind the curtain. He sat right there next to Du'bul. As he recited the verses of poetry, Imam al-Ridha started crying and weeping, it is said. He started shouting, Aywa jaddah wa husayna. And that's what we read also in the ziyarah of Ashura, which will be recited later on today, inshallah. This great ziyarah, where the Imam alayhi salam is addressed as the martyr, as the commander, as the leader, where we pray, Allahumma ahyina hayata Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad, wa amitna mamata Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. O Lord, make us live the life of Muhammad and his family and die the way they died. And then the Imam prays for the reappearance of our master, the 12th Imam, so that we can join him in commemorating the martyrdom of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. For believe me, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, in such a day and such a time, Imam al-Mahdi is weeping for the loss of his grandfather, Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So from today, Try to learn from Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. Try to follow his footsteps and his path. Tell Imam Hussein the words of Imam al-Mahdi in Ziyar al-Nahiya, where he tells him, if I was not there in my body and my person to support you, Ya Hussein, my voice called, my spirit called, my soul called to come and support you and to follow your path, Ya Aba Abdullah. So from today, pay your allegiance to Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. Support Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us his ziyarah in this dunya and his shafa'ah in the akhirah. Ya ayyuhal muhrul mukhadzabu bid-dima, ya la taqsidanna khiyaman nisa'il dhiya'i. يا أيها المهر المخضب بالدماء لا تقصدن خيم النساء الضيعين يخاف بأن تروع قلبها وهي التي ما عودت بتروع لهفي لها إذ رأته عافرا بلجامه أبدت لذياك النعي ولزينب ندب لفقد شقيقها تدعوه يا ابن الزاكيات الركعي اليوم أصبغ في عزاك ملابسي أخي يا حسين اليوم أصبغ في عزاك ملابسي سودا وأسكبها طلات أدمعي اليوم شبوا نارهم في محملي وتناهبوا ما فيه حتى برقعي ابو فاضل قوم لنا حرقوا خيمنا علينا اليوم شبوا نارهم في محملي وتناهبوا ما فيه حتى برقعي اليوم ساقوني بأسري يا أخي وضرب الصياط أيوا ويلاه وزينب وضرب الصياط آلمني وأطفالي معي أخي ما عودتني منك الجفا فعلى ما تجفوني وتجفو من معي أخي أين أبي علي المرتضى ليرنك ساري للعدا أيوا ويلا حيدر يا أبويا ما تجينا حيدر يا أبويا ما تجينا يا أبا تشوفنا شلون نسبينا يا
الغابة والناس تتفرج علينا بويا صرنا نتستر بدينا أخي أين أبي علي المرتضى ليرى انكسار يا للعداء وتخضعي أنعم جوابا يا حسين أما ترى شمر الخنا بالصوت كسر فأجابها من فوق شاهقة القناة قضي القضاء يا زينب فاستايا يا رجعي
On the morning of Ashura, after Imam Hussein prayed Salat al-Subh among his companions, then he called them over and he started telling them that this is the day when we will be facing our Lords. This is the day that you'll be meeting my grandfather Rasulullah. Then he called upon Habib ibn Mazahir and he told him, you'll take care of the right wing of the army. Then he called Zuhair ibn al-Qayn and he told him, you'll take care of the left wing of the army. And he stayed among his family in the center. Then he gave the banner to Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. And he said, oh my brother, you are the carrier of the banner of Hussein. Then he started admonishing his companions. Afterwards, the companions asked permission to admonish the enemies of Allah and the army of Umar ibn Sa'd. Imam Hussein gave them permission. So Habib ibn Mazahir went out and he started admonishing everybody, saying, oh people, don't you know that this is the Prophet's grandson? Why do you want to fight against him? Why don't you leave him instead of at least not supporting him? Just let him go back to Medina. Then they started throwing arrows at him. After that, some other companions admonished those enemies of Allah, and they were thrown with the arrows. Then Imam Hussein alayhi salam rode his horse, and he approached the enemies, calling them, oh people, don't you know that I am the grandson of Rasulullah? They said, yes, we do. They said, don't you know that I am the son of Fatima al-Zahra, the Prophet's daughter? They said, yes, we do. He said, don't you know I am the son of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, the first person who believed in the message of Rasulullah? They said, yes, we do. He said, don't you know that Ja'far al-Tayyar is my uncle? They said, yes, we do. He said, don't you know that's the leader of the martyrs, Hamza, who was martyred in the battle of Uhud, is the uncle of my father? They said, yes, we do. He said, do you realize that there is no grandson today in the east and the west of the Prophet Muhammad other than me? They said, yes, we do. He said, then why do you want to fight against me if you know all these things? Why don't you come and support me? If you don't want to support me, then why don't you leave me? Go back to Medina where I came from. That's when Umar ibn Sa'd called. He said that we shall not leave you until you pay the allegiance to Yazid ibn Muawiyah, or we have to fight against you. Then Imam Hussein says, Ya Aballahu lana dhalik wa rasuluh, that Allah has forbidden
for us to pay the allegiance to a person like Yazid ibn Muawiyah, who is an oppressor, who is a tyrant, who respects no humanity and human dignity. إن اللعين ابن اللعين قد ركز بين اثنتين بين السلة والذلة وهيهات من الذلة. والله لا أعطي بيدي إعطاء الذليل ولا أقر إقرار العبيد. He said, the sinner, referring to Yazid ibn Muawiyah, who is the son of the sinner, he has given us only two options, either to pay the allegiance to him and live in humility, or to fight and die in this battle. And I shall never pay the allegiance to him. I'd rather die with dignity and honor, for these are the teachings of my grandfather, Rasulullah. These are the teachings of my father, Amir al-Mu'mineen. These are the teachings of my mother, Fatima al-Zahra. These are the teachings of my grandmother, Khadija al-Kubra. He says, I will never pay the allegiance like a weak man. I am a strong person. I come from a great family with integrity and honor from the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. When Hurr ibn Yazid al-Riyahi heard this, he approached Umar ibn Sa'd and he said, Ya Umar, amuqatilun anta hadha? Are you going to fight against this man, referring to Imam Hussein? Umar ibn Sa'd said, yes indeed, a very severe battle where heads and arms will be severed from their bodies. Then Hurr ibn Yazid came back and his companion, the man who was standing next to him, he saw Hurr ibn Yazid trembling and shaking. He said, Ya Hurr, why are you shaking? For by God, if they ask me to name the bravest man in Kufa, I would not hesitate to name you. He said, I am comparing myself and questioning myself, or between choosing Jannah and the hellfire, and by God, I will never choose anything other than Jannah. Then he kicked his horse, approaching the camp of Imam Hussein, having his hands over his head, and he tucked his head down, approaching Imam Hussein in embarrassment. قال يا ابن رسول الله أنا صاحبك الذي قطع عليك الطريق أنا الذي جئت بعيالك إلى هنا. Oh my master, I am the one who brought you here. I am the reason that was that your family and your children came to Karbala. I am the one who intercepted your path from going to Kufa and brought you here to Karbala. Oh my master, هل لي من توبة؟ Can I seek forgiveness and repentance? Imam Hussein عليه السلام told him, إن تبت تاب الله عليك. If you're seeking true repentance, then Allah سبحانه وتعالى will forgive you. Then he said, Oh my master, do you give me permission to talk to the people, the enemies of Umar ibn Sa'd, the army of Umar ibn Sa'd? He said, yes indeed. Hur came back and he said, Oh people, I am your commander. Oh people, I was your leader. Look at me, I changed sides to the truth. Don't stay in the vanity and the batil. Come and support the Prophet's grandson, Hussein. But the people started throwing arrows at Hurr ibn Yazid. So then he came back and he said, Ya ibn Rasulullah, do you give me permission to be the first man to die before you, supporting you in Karbala? Imam Hussein alayhi salam said, yes indeed. He went outside fighting bravely. أنا الحور ومأوى الضيف أضرب أعناقكم بالسيف. He's saying, I am Hur, I am the honored man, I shall fight you with my sword. And he fought against them bravely until he was heavily wounded and he fell on the plains of Karbala as the first martyr with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Imam Hussein walked to him Just before he dies, Imam Hussein wiped his face and said, بخن بخن لك يا حور أنت الحر كما سمتك أمك حر في الدنيا وسعيد في الآخرة. Congratulations, O Hur, and well done for what you have done. Indeed, you are a free man, a man who's free from the desires of this world, and you shall be pleased and happy on the hereafter, joining me and my grandfather, Rasulullah. Then Hur died in that moment, and the enemy started throwing the arrows at the companions of Imam Hussein, until each one of his companions got hit by an arrow. That's when Imam Hussein alayhi salam said, قوموا رحمكم الله إلى الموت الذي لا بد منه هذه رسل القوم إليكم. He said, now you have the permission to fight, for here are the messages of those enemies coming to us. They don't want to give us the chance to go back. They only want us to fight. So let's fight and die in honor. And indeed, they started fighting so bravely, one after the other. And they were dying right before the eyes of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. While he was seeing this, whenever he saw one of his companions get martyred, he said, إِنَّا لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. And among them he was reciting these verses in the Quran, and among them are men who truly fulfill their promises, referring to his companions who were so loyal and faithful to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So among them are those who have been martyred and killed, and there are those who are waiting for their martyrdom, until a man by the name of Muslim ibn Awsajah comes to Imam Hussein. As he was leaving his tent, his wife came after him. She said, oh my husband, ya Muslim, don't leave me to live in this world after you. Why do you want to leave me all alone? His mother came to him and she said, go and support Imam Hussein. So Muslim came to Imam Hussein and said, O Ibn Rasulullah, اذن لي بالخروج. Imam Hussein gave him the permission to fight. He went back to the battle, fighting very bravely until his hands got cut off. He came back and he said to his mom, are you pleased with me? She said, no, not until you die supporting the cause of Allah before Imam Hussein. That's when his wife came after him. She said, oh my husband, ya Muslim, let me join you in the battle. Let me come and fight next to you. Muslim said, what changed you? A few moments ago you were telling me not to fight, and now you want to come and join me. قالت يا مسلم لا تلمني إن واعية الحسين أدمت قلبي. Muslim, don't blame me. I just heard the call of Imam Hussein, which really made me burst in tears. He said, what did you hear him say? He said, I heard him standing there in Karbala calling, أمام الناصر ينصرنا أمام معين يعيننا أمام طالب للجنة يطلبنا. Isn't there anyone who will come and help us? Isn't there anyone to support us? Isn't there anyone to support the cause of Allah and the messenger of Rasulullah? Muslim told her, then that's fine. She came with him. He went to Imam Hussein, asked him, can you please tell my wife to go back to the tent? So Imam Hussein came to her and said, may Allah bless you, go back to the tent. So she returned back, and Muslim indeed fought bravely until he was heavily wounded. He fell on the plains of Karbala. Then Habib ibn Mazahir al-Asadi and Imam Hussein walked together to Muslim ibn Awsajah.
Just before he dies, Habib told him, Ya Muslim, rahimakallah, if I knew that I am gonna live much longer after you, I would have asked you to give me your will. Then Muslim said, Yes, Ya Habib, I have a will to give you. He said, What is it? Qala Ya Habib, Allah, Allah, بهذا الغريب قاتل حتى تقتل دون قربات يا بن ظاهر منيتين قربات يا بن ظاهر منيتين أنا ما وصيك بعيالي وأهل بيتي بالحسين ولا وصيت ذن إمام حسين سد رحمك الله يا مسلم قاتلت دوننا حيا وأوصيت بنا ميتا إمام حسين told him may Allah bless you يا مسلم you fought before us and supported us when you had the strength and just now before you die you give your will of supporting us may Allah bless you and may Allah make you with my grandfather in Jannah. That's when Muslim smiled and left this world, joining Rasulullah in Jannah. After that, Habib ibn Madahir came fighting very bravely, shouting out, Ana Habib, Ana Habib, I am Habib, I am from the family of Madahir, I am the son of Madahir, I will fight against you very bravely. And indeed, he fought so bravely until he was hit with a spear in his chest and he fell on the plains of Karbala saying wa alayka minni salam ya Abu Abdullah they say when Imam Hussein heard and saw this Habib his companion fell on the plains of Karbala he was extremely moved and hurt and he said inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un then a man by the name of John who was a servant working for Abu Dharr al-Ghafari. He came and he said, Ya Aba Abdullah, I'd like you to give me the permission to fight in this war. Imam Hussein did not distinguish between a black man or a white man, between an Arab and a non-Arab, between a companion and his own children. Even though John was a black man and he was a black servant, yet Imam Hussein respected him and honored him. And he told him, Ya John, why do you want to die before me? I give you the permission to leave me and go away. Then John started kissing the feet of Imam Hussein, saying, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, please give me the permission to have the honor of shaking the hands of your grandfather Rasulullah in Jannah. Imam Hussein gave him the permission. He went out to fight in the battle very bravely. Until he was heavily wounded and fell on the plains of Karbala. It is said Imam Hussein walked to him. He put his cheeks on the cheeks of Joan. And just before he died, Joan opened his eyes and said, Man mithli wa khad ibn Rasulillah ala khaddi. Who's like me when the cheeks of the Prophet's grandson is touching my cheeks? And Imam Hussein does the same thing to his son Ali al-Akbar. This is to teach us that Imam Hussein did not distinguish and discriminate amongst people and companions until Joan died peacefully. Then a man came to Imam Hussein in the middle of the battle by the name of Abu Thumam al-Sa'idi. And he said, Oh my master, I see the time of noon approaching. Shall we pray? Imam Hussein, of course, knew of that, but he wanted to teach us about the greatness of his companions and how much they respected Salat. Imam Hussein said, ذكرت الصلاة جعلك الله من المصلين في الدنيا والآخرة. آخرة. You remember salat, may Allah make you among those who establish salat in this world and the hereafter. And then they stand there praying. Imam Hussein puts two men in front of him while he leads the salat. Those men were guarding the entire army and guarding Imam Hussein. As the enemies threw their arrows, these two men stood firm and solid until Imam Hussein finished his salat. They lost their strength and fell there on the plains of Karbala, having more than 20 arrows in their bodies. Then they looked at Imam Hussein and they said, Ya ibn Rasulullah, hal waffayna ma'ak? Oh, the Prophet's grandson, did we do enough to support you and your cause? He said, may Allah bless you both. I will pray and ask Allah to make you enter Jannah with me, inshallah. Then after that, the martyrs and the companions of Imam Hussein started going one after the other, fighting very bravely, one after the other. And Imam Hussein is calling, Imam Nasir yansurna, Imam Mu'in yu'inuna, Imam Talib liljannati yatlubuna. Until the last two men came to Imam Hussein, the last two companions, they were crying, saying, Ya ibn Rasulullah, i'dhan lana fil khuruj. Imam Hussein said, why are you crying? Why are you weeping? They said, Ya ibn Rasulullah, because we are the last two men left with you. We're crying because once we die, you will be left with no more companions. Companions, you will be all alone in Karbala. Imam Hussein said, Rahimakum Allah, idhaba wa sallima li ala jaddi Rasulullah. May Allah bless you. Go to the battle, and when you meet my grandfather Rasulullah, give him my salam. And those two men started fighting bravely until they died. May Allah bless their souls. That's when Imam Hussein looked around. There was no one with him. So a young boy came from the camp. Imam Hussein recognized him. His father had just been martyred in the battle. The boy was Ibn Wahab. Imam Hussein alayhi salam told him, oh young boy, young man who was only 11 years old, go back to the tent for your mother is probably looking for you. He said, no, Ya ibn Rasulullah, my mom is the one who told me to come and support you. My father just joined your grandfather Rasulullah in martyrdom in Jannah, and I would like to join my father and your grandfather Rasulullah in Jannah. So please give me the permission to fight before you. Imam Hussein gave him the permission. He came out calling the people, Amiri Hussein wa ni'mal amir, Sururu Fuad al-Bashir al-Nadhir, Fatimatun wa Ali أبواه فهل تعلمون له من نظير. He said, my master is Imam Hussein, and what a great master he is. He is the son of Fatima and Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali. Do you know of any son in the world today who has such great parents as Fatima and Ali? And he fought so bravely until he died. Then they cut off his head and send it to the camp. His mother picked up on his head and she started wiping it and wiping the blood and the dirt, saying, well done my son, well done. I will tell Fatima al-Zahra when I meet her about this. I am so proud of you.
That's when Imam Hussein turned around, and now there was no more companions to support him. Oh Shia, oh my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we wish we were there with Imam Hussein to tell him Labbayka ya ibn Rasulillah. Then he started calling again, Amam al-Nasir yansuruna, Amam al-Mu'in yu'inuna, Amam al-Talib lil-Jannati yatlubuna. Then he looked towards the tents, and there is his son Ali al-Akbar coming out of the tent, walking with all integrity and honor, as if it was Rasulullah walking towards Imam Hussein. When Imam Hussein saw him, he started crying. Ali al-Akbar approached him and he said, Oh father, do you give me the permission to go and fight before you? Imam Hussein alayhi salam hugged him, he kissed him. Then he couldn't say yes, but instead he lifted his hands and he said, Allahumma ashhad ala ula'i القوم. خرج إليهم أشبه الناس خلقا وخلقا ومنطقا بنبيك محمد. Oh Allah, bear witness on those enemies and what they are doing to us. Here is a man who is now going to go and fight them, who most resembles your Rasul, your messenger, your prophet Muhammad, in his looks and his manners and characters and his speech. That's when Ali al-Akbar understands that now he has the permission to fight in the battle. He rides his horse and fights very bravely, calling the enemies, Ana Ali ibn al-Husayn ibn Ali, نحن وبيت الله يا أولى بالنبي, أضربكم بالسيف حتى يصطلي, ضرب غلام هاشمي علوي, والله لا يحكم فينا ابن الدعي. And he started fighting bravely, calling, I am Ali, the son of Hussein, who's the son of Ali. I come from the Prophet's family. We will fight with integrity and honor. We will support the cause of Allah and the message of Rasulullah by defending our father and master, Imam Hussein. Then he fought so bravely. After some time, he came back to his father. He said, Oh, my father, I bid my farewell to you again. Then Imam Hussein said, May Allah bless you, Ya Ali. But this time, Imam Hussein rode his horse because he knew this would be the last time where he would be seeing his son, Ali al-Akbar. That's when Ali al-Akbar went back to the battle. He fought bravely until an enemy of Allah approached him and he struck him on the head with a sword. Another man came and hit him in his chest with a spear. That's when Ali al-Akbar called, Aba alayka minni salam. Oh my father, I send you my regard. Here I see my grandfather Rasulullah. Here I see my grandmother Fatima. Here I see my grandfather Ali ibn Abi Talib. And here I see my uncle Imam al-Hassan. They're all saying, Ya Hussein, we are waiting for you to come to us shortly. Imam Hussein ran after Ali al-Akbar. He threw himself from the horse on the body of his son, calling, Waladi Ali, Waladi Ali, Waladi Ali. على الدنيا بعدك العفا يا بناي بناي بعدا لقوم قتلوك يا ابن سعد قطع الله رحمك كما قطعت رحمي instead of my son I wish I did not live to see this moment when you are lying there in Karbala with a spear in your chest with a wound of the sword on your head and you are covered in blood علي راح علي راح قعد عنده وصفق راح على رايح شافه والنبل نابت على جراح علي راح بكى ونادى يا زينب علي راح وانا ضمت الدنيا علي Then he called, Oh, Bani Hashim, come and lift Ali, my son, for I don't have the energy to carry him to the tent. They carried him to the tent. That's when his aunt Zainab came. Salat, aywa, Ali, aywa, walada. Then shortly after, Imam Hussein was waiting there, and that's when a young handsome boy came out of the tent. Imam Hussein looked at him, this face so bright and pure like the moon in the middle of the night. This was Qasim ibn al-Hassan. He approached his uncle. He said, Ya am idhalli bil khuruj. Oh my uncle, give me the permission to go and fight before you. He was only 11 or 12 years of age. Imam Hussein alayhi salam hugged him. He kissed him. He smelled him. He said, Oh my nephew, oh my son, whenever I miss your father, Imam al-Hassan, I would smell you and you remind me of your father, Imam al-Hassan. Oh my son, how can I give you the permission to go and fight? I still remember losing your father, Imam al-Hassan. How can I now lose you, his son? He said, Oh uncle, please give me the permission to fight before you, for this will please my father, Imam al-Hassan in Jannah. Then Imam al-Hussein said, Okay. He brought him the imam, the turban of his father, Imam al-Hassan. He gave him the sword of his father, Imam al-Hassan. He gave him the armor of Imam al-Hassan. And he said, Go and face those enemies of Allah. He took the sword bravely, calling, In tunkirani, fa'ana najlu al-Hassan. In tunkirani, fa'ana najlu al-Hassan. Sibtu al-Nabi al-Mustafa wal-Mu'taman. Hada حسين كالأسير المرتهن وسط أناس لا سقوا صوب المزن If you don't know who I am Qasim, the son of Hassan. I shall fight you and support the cause of my uncle, Imam Hussein. Indeed, he fought so bravely until it is said that his left sandal got cut off. So he started fixing it. A man of the enemy said, I'm going to hurt this boy and murder him. And I'm going to hurt his uncle, Imam Hussein, by killing him. A man was standing next to this enemy. Among the enemies, he said, Why do you want to hurt this boy? Look how handsome he is. Look how beautiful he is. By God, if he comes to me and kills me, I would not even touch him. He said, No, I'm going to hurt his uncle by killing him. He goes after him. As Qasim was fixing his shoe, the enemy struck him on his head with a sword that made him fall on the plains of Karbala calling السلام عليك من السلام I'm Abba Abdullah. Oh, my uncle here, I see my father, Imam al-Hassan. He's sending his salams to you and he says, Oh, brother, come to us shortly. We're waiting for you. Imam Hussein rushed to him. He murdered his murderer. Then he sat next to him saying, Ay waladi, ay waladi. يعز على عمك أن يجيبك فلا يعينك. Oh, it really hurts your uncle that he sees you in this state, in this situation where he cannot do much to help you. Then he carries him back to the tent. جاب ومدد ما بين أخوته. جاب ومدد ما بين أخوته. قعد عدهم يا ويلي وهم موت بس ما سمع عن النسوان صوته. طلعت سكنة تصيح الله أكبر. Then Imam Hussein was left there, seeing his family one after the other being martyred, the children of Aqil, the children of Hussein, one after the other. His cousin started fighting, his brother started fighting one after the other, until he was left with no one anymore in his family except Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, the bearer of the command and the banner of Hussein. He came to him and he said, Ya Aba Abdullah, اذن لي بالخروج فلقد ضاق صدري. Oh my brother, Ya Hussein, Oh my master, Ya Hussein, give me the permission to go and fight before you, for I cannot wait any longer to fight these enemies of Allah. Imam Hussein was shaken at that moment, my brothers and sisters. He said, Ya Aba al-Fadl, anta sahibu liwa'i, anta kafilu mahmili. Ya Aba al-Fadl, in dhabta anni, ala jam'i ila shitat, saqata liwa'i, tafarraqa askari. Oh brother Abbas, you are the one who's carrying the banner of your master Hussein. Hussein, if you go, who's going to carry the banner of Hussein? Oh brother, you are the one who's taking care of the family and the children of Hussein. If you go, who will take care of Zainab, Sukaina, Ruqayya? Who will take care of the children of Hussein? But if it is indeed you must go to fight, then go get some water for the children of Hussein who are thirsty for 3 days. So Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas grabs the bucket of water, the bag of water, and he heads towards the water, the river of Furat. As he is calling very bravely, أنا العباس أغدو بالسقاء. I am Abbas coming to get the water. I am the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib. I am the brave one and the supporter of Hussein. It is said he managed to disperse all the 4,000 men who Umar ibn Sa'd put them there to block the path of Imam Hussein from reaching to the water. He dispersed them all and he managed to make his way to the water of Furat. Then the enemies say, we saw him dipping his hands in the water. He lifted the water to drink, but he never did, and he let go of the water. We didn't know why he was doing this until he started reciting this verses of poetry. Ya nafs min ba'd al-Husayni فبعده ما كنت كنت أن تكوني. هذا حسين وارد المنون وتشربين بارد المعين. والله ماذا فعال ديني ولا فعال صادق اليقين. Oh my soul, how can you drink the water when your master Hussein is all thirsty? This is not the teachings of my religion. This is not the teachings of my father. This is not the teachings of the Quran. I will fight supporting Hussein. Look at the loyalty of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. Imam al-Sadiq says the body of Abu al-Fadl was burning like a charcoal from the thirst, yet he still did not drink the water of Furat. Then he filled the bag of the water and headed back to the tent. His whole mission and his whole task is to get the bag of water to the tent so that Zainab, Sukaina, Abdullah can drink the water. He never gave up hope until a man came and cut off his right arm. Aywa wayla wa Abbasa. Then he started calling, Wallah in qata'tum yamini. إني حامي أبدا عن ديني وعن إمام صادق اليقين. سبط النبي المصطفى الأمين. He then took the water in his left arm and the sword as well with the banner of Hussein. He never let go of the banner of Imam Hussein. He said, even if you cut off my right arm, I'll still defend my master Imam Hussein and the path of Allah. Then another enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hit him on his left arm and he cut off his left arm. Ya nafs, ya nafs, la takhshay min al-kuffari wa abshiri bi rahmat al-jabbari. قطعوا ببغيهم يساري فصلهم يا رب حر النار. He said, O enemies, even if you cut off my left arm, that will never stop me from completing my mission and serving Imam Hussein. Then he headed to the tent and all his task was to get the water to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. He never gave up hope. He never felt the pain. But the pain was felt when the arrow of the enemy came and hit the bag of the water. And all the water was spilled. That's when Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas felt the pain. Then another arrow came and hit him in the eye. Yet he was still hanging on to the banner of Hussein until a man came to him with an iron pillar بعمد من حديد فضرب العباس على رأسه. He hit him with an iron pillar. That's when the banner of Hussein fell down. That's when Abu al-Fadl fell off his horse calling, Akhi Hussein, Adrik Akhayak. Oh brother, come and see your brother Abbas. Imam Hussein rushed to him. He managed to get close to him. He saw him with no right arm, with no left arm. There is an arrow in his eye. He has been wounded by an iron pillar on the head. قال أخي أبا الفضل الآن انكسر ظهري. وقلت حيلتي وشمت بعدوي. Oh brother Abbas, now I feel that I am all alone in Karbala. Oh brother Abbas, now it is when my women and my children have fallen as prisoners to Bani Umayyah. Oh brother Abbas, what am I to say to Zainab? He wanted to carry him, but he said, leave me. يقول لي أخويا خليني بمجاني. يقول لي ليش يا زهرة زماني. يقول لي وعدت سكنة تراني. أجيب الماي ولا الخيام أصدر. ذن إمام حسين عليه السلام went back walking to the tents. That's when Zainab saw him. She said, يا أخي أبا عبد الله, where is my brother Abbas? قال لا يا زينب عظم الله لك الأجر. I just came from the river of Furat. Abbas lost his right arm. He lost his left arm. He joined my father, Amir al-Mu'minin. That's when Zainab cried, Aywa Abbas, cry with her, Aywa Abbas. أيوا أخا أيوا ضيعته بعدك. فصاح الحسين أي والله وضيعته بعدك. يقل يا زينب راح عباس عباس راح الضغم اللي يرفع الراس. Then Imam Hussein alayhi salam came to bid farewell to his family. He said, oh, farewell to all of you. He came to bid farewell to Zainab alayhi salam, to his daughter Sukaina. He saw her tears flowing. She said, oh, my father, I can see that this is the last farewell. You will be leaving us shortly. Imam Hussein started to comfort her. He said, oh, Sukaina, don't make me see your tears, for it really hurts your father to see your tears. I say, Abu Abdullah, I wish you were there after your martyrdom to see the tears of Sukaina. Then Imam Hussein alayhi salam rode his horse to go back to the battlefield to go and fight. That's when Zainab called him. She said, Ya Akhi, يا أبا عبد الله, هذا رضيعك. Here is your baby, Abdullah. He has not had any water for 3 days. He's going to die of thirst. Why don't you ask those people to give him some water? Imam Hussein alayhi salam took his baby to the battlefield. He called, O Umar ibn Sa'd, O people of Bani Umayyah, إن كان للكبار ذنب فما ذنب هذا الرضيع. If we the men may have committed a crime or done something wrong, what has this baby done to you? Why do you want to fight against him and leave him die thirsty? Take him and give him some water and bring him back to me. That is when the army of Umar ibn Sa'd split. Some people said, yes, let's give the baby some water, for he has no crime or no sin against us. The others said, no, let all the family of Hussein die of thirst, even the baby. لا تدعوا لهذا البيت من أحد. Don't leave anyone for this people. And then Umar ibn Sa'd turned to Harmala, the Arab man. He said, يا حرملة انزع خصام القوم. Oh, Harmala, cut out the controversy and the discussion. Harmala said, what do you want me to do? He said, don't you see the neck of the baby? It is shining so beautifully. Put your arrow in his neck. Harmala said, I put the arrow. And then I threw the arrow at this baby. While he was being carried by his father, Imam Hussein, the arrow pierced his neck from one end to the other. On his father's hands, Imam Hussein said, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Then the baby started hitting his hands and his legs as if he was calling, Oh father, why did they kill me? Why did they murder me? Imam Hussein alayhi salam took some of his blood and he threw it in the sky. It is said not a single drop came back. And he said, اللهم تقبل منا هذا القربان هون علي ما نزل بي أنه بعين الله اللهم إن كان هذا يرضيك فخذ حتى ترضى Oh Allah, if this is pleasing you, then take from us everything you want until you are fully pleased. Then he came back to the tent. Zainab alayhi salam said, Oh Aba Abdullah, did you get the water to Abdullah? He said, No, but my grandfather Rasulullah gave him the water in Jannah. Ya Zainab, he was pierced from one end of his throat to the other. When his mother Rabab looked at him, she cried, Aywa walada, Aywa bunayya, bi ayy dhanbin qataluk. Ya bni, ana lawan nadri turuh lajl al-may. Ana chint asqik bdam ana rabay. Then Imam Hussein alayhi salam bid his farewell with his family. And then he started fighting bravely, saying, Ana al-Hussein ibn Ali, alayt an la anthani. I am Hussein, the son of Ali. I have taken a promise and an oath to Allah that I shall defend the message of Rasulullah until the last moment. And he fought so bravely, a man of the enemies by the name of Hamid ibn Muslim. يقول والله ما رأيت رجلا قد قتل أصحابه وولده أربط جأشا وشجاعة من هذا الحسين. He said, I والله I have not seen a man who had just lost all his companions and his family members, yet he is fighting so bravely that the men of Umar ibn Sa'd are running away from him. Like little sheep running away from their wolf. And Imam Hussein fought so bravely. Then he came back to the tent one more time. And he called, Ya Zainab, هذا الوداع الأخير. Oh Zainab, this is the last farewell. Oh Zainab, take care of my children after me. Oh Zainab, you'll not see me after this, but you'll see my body wounded. Then he gave all the farewell. He came to Sukaina, he kissed her, he wiped his hand over her head, and then he rode his horse, fighting so bravely. The enemies of Allah started throwing him with rocks, with arrows, with spears, with swords, until he was heavily wounded. Then he got off his horse. He sat down next on the plains of Karbala. That's when an enemy threw an arrow with three heads at his chest, that pierced his chest. It is said that Imam Hussein took the arrow from the back and his liver came out with the arrow. Then as he was sitting there, another man hit him with a rock on his head. الولد. أيوة حسينا، أيوة سيدة. Then the blood started to flow all over his face. He started taking the blood and wiping and dyeing his beard with it. And he said, هكذا ألقى جدي مخضبا بدمي أشكو إليه من صنع هؤلاء القوم. This is how I'm going to meet my grandfather Rasulullah, covered in blood. So I'll complain to him what his nation has done to me. And then as he was sitting down, Umar ibn Sa'd said, let's go and attack the tents of Hussein. They came after the tents. Imam Hussein gathered his strength and yelled, Ya Umar ibn Sa'd, Ya Ala Abi Sufyan, إن لم تكونوا مسلمين فكونوا أعرابا كما تدعون. ما لك وما لنسائي. Oh Umar ibn Sa'd, why are you going after my women and my children? Oh people of Bani Umayyah, if you don't even have a religion of Islam to follow, then be Arab, be Arabs like you claim, and don't attack my women and my children while I am still alive. That's when Umar ibn Sa'd said, okay, leave the women alone, go after Hussein. So people started hitting him with the swords. They started throwing him with arrows. They started hitting him with rocks. Then they came close to Hussein. It is said that's when the horse of Imam Hussein started kicking them and shouting. Umar ibn Sa'd said, let's leave the horse, see what does it do. The horse came. He came to Imam Hussein. He put his face on the blood of Imam Hussein. Then he headed back to the tent, crying. Imam al-Sadiq was asked, what was the horse saying? He said he was saying, الظلمة الظلمة من أمة قتلت ابن بنت نبيها. The horse was crying, woe upon those people who murdered the grandson of their prophet. When Zainab alayhi salam heard the cry of the horse, she came out of the tent. She saw the horse covered in blood, and Hussein was not there on the horse. She started crying, aywa kha, aywa Hussein. أيوة سيدة. Then Umar ibn Sa'd said, oh people, come and finish Hussein. A man came next to Imam Hussein. He said, I saw him there. When I looked into his eyes, I got frightened. I've never seen a man who was covered in blood, yet he was so handsome like Hussein. So I threw my sword and I ran away. Another man came. He said, I saw Hussein uttering some words. So I thought I'd listen to him. He was saying, إلهي تركت الخلق طرا في هواك وأيتمت العيال لكي أراك فإن قطعتني بالسيف إربا ما مال الفؤاد إلى سواك. Oh my Lord, I gave up everything for your sake. And even if you cut me in the sword by pieces, I'll still not love anyone else but you. That's when Hashim ibn al-Jawshan came next to Imam. He kicked the Imam. Then he sat on his chest. Aywa Sayyida. Yeah. That's when Zainab got out of the tent. She said, Ya Hashem, leave Hussein alone. But then he hit Zainab, alayhi salam. Then she turned towards Umar ibn Sa'd. She said, Ya Umar, ayuqtal al-Hussein. Wa anta waqif. Is Hussein being murdered and you standing there not doing anything? It is said he turned away from her. Then a nephew, a son of Imam al-Hassan, came out. He jumped on the body of Imam Hussein. He said to Shimr, leave my uncle alone. Shimr hit him. He cut off his right arm. He looked at his uncle. He said, my uncle, look, they cut off my arm. Imam Hussein comforted him. He said, be patient, my son. You'll be joining your father in Jannah shortly. And then Shimr killed that young boy. Then he took Imam Hussein, turned him on his back. Aywa wayla wa sayyida. Then he started severing that of Hussein. شيعتي مهما شربتم عذب ماء فاذكروني أو رأيتم من قتيل أو شهيد فاندبوني فأنا السبط الذي من غير جرم قتلوني.